Game Bytes Show podcast. I am Jeremy Lawman Lamont, and we're going to be playing Sins of a Solar Empire. I am going to commence immediately. We are foregoing any formalities. We're going to jump right into this thing. So we are just basically going to make sure that we get a good session with Sins of a Solar Empire. Since I am alone tonight, normally Jared Red-Eye Dunn is in charge of things, but since he is not here, that means I get to do whatever I want. And moreover, it means that I get to do whatever Jared would want, but isn't here to actually do. So he's going to be super jealous of us for getting to share this time together. So we're going to get started. This is one of our all-time favorite 4X games. I'm speaking for me and Jared here. And it's not new. In fact, I think this came out in 2000. I mean, originally, so it's actually on like its fourth or fifth iteration at this point. And originally came out quite a while ago. Let's see, when did this come out? 2008, actually. Oh man, I accidentally started out with a different team than I had planned. What is going on here? So let's get this thing done. So first of all, we're in outer space. This is my little home world here. And we'd better start building a capital ship. Let's see, we want something that is going to colonize some stuff. So one of the cool things, first of all, about Sins of a Solar Empire is the fact that you can zoom way in, so we can actually watch that battleship being built, and you can kind of see it filling in solid there, like you can sort of see it. So it's building in there. So you can zoom way in, or you can zoom way the heck out, and it's all real time. So this is a 4X game, an actual strategy game full of strategery, and making sure that everything's working here. All right. And we also have little ships and stuff. So we're going to go ahead and start telling them to go search some stuff out. So we are playing apparently as the Advent, which is, if in this game there is a kind of a Zerg humans Protoss kind of idea, these guys would probably be the Protoss. That's probably the best analogy I can make here. So this game is all about branching out from your home world, finding new areas. All of the places that you can move are limited to these areas. And they have little guys who are going to come and try and get me. But we get to kind of look at the planets. So this is basically going to be like a dwarf planet full of asteroids and stuff. But we need to focus on some things here. So we're building our capital ship, and in fact, it is ready to go. My beautiful 1980s gun-shaped ship here. We're going to assign that to Group 1. We're going to build some friends for him. Actually, we're also going to give him some bombers. Capital ships are kind of the main ships of the line here. And we're going to level him up, and we are going to build some dudes. We want some disciples. And in fact, we're going to say any disciples that get built, send them to him, and we're going to send him off to... Where did that dwarf planet go? Is that the one we ended up on? No, we ended up on this one. So let's go. So we're in a tiny... I set this up to be a tiny playing field, and you can see there's sort of some three-dimensionality to it. What's that? Asteroids. You can't really colonize asteroids yet, so we're going to leave that one alone. We want this dwarf planet. So in Sins of a Solar Empire, let's watch this phase jump. It's always fun to watch things zip off into light speed here. Boom. Leaving everything you knew behind. And here we are already at this dwarf planet. And sending off the bombers. You can zoom all the way in on the bombers and watch them kind of do their thing. In fact, my dude is going to probably try and colonize something, and I don't want him to do that quite yet. Reason is that some of the ships that are here They're just gonna bomb the planet. So you guys need to attack some people here. Attack. Get that guy. You get that guy. Oh, let's see what the bombers are doing. Zoom on in. Let's see them do their thing. Oh, we just colonized that planet. Crap. Which actually isn't a bad thing. It's just that this guy right here. All right, everybody, all hands. Kill that thing. Because here's the thing. This dude is specced out to bomb that planet. And because they're such a little fledgling dwarf planet and they don't have a lot of HP, technically he could do some bad stuff. So we want to kill him before he. Oh. I think he might be. Yeah, there he goes. So he's actually already shooting. He is bombarding that planet, which I didn't really intend to happen. So our planet health right now is 303. You can see over there. There's a lot of things to keep track of in this game. So yeah, he's basically raining down fire and brimstone on my new little planet there. All right, finally got him. Oh man. Okay. So in the meantime, more stuff going on here. More of my dudes. In fact, all of you now are Group One. And we colonized this planet, so let's talk about some of the things that you can do when you build a planet. Every planet, whether it's your home planet or not, in fact, we're gonna move everybody out. I'm gonna send them off to do their thing while we do some domesticated kinds of things here. So, that's assembly drones. Everything in your home system is made by these drones. And when you zoom out far enough, all you can see are these icons here. But you know, there's your little frigate factories. Frigates are sort of your middle ships. That's my capital ship factory to build super big things. They're not the biggest things, but we're gonna see that maybe by the end of this game. I don't know. But we are going to build some new stuff here. Within a planet, you can either develop logistics, like what the capacity of the planet or what the focus of the planet is. Every planet has tactical capacity and logistics capacity. And what those things mean are those are tactical are sort of your attacking, defense kinds of things, things that shoot stuff. For tactical and logistics structures, those are things like your research hubs. So in here we have temples of hostility, temples of harmony. We're gonna do a temple of harmony, and it's gonna send our little frigate guy off to build it. We are also gonna go ahead and build a. Oh, you know what? I think we need some more logistics here. This little world symbol at the bottom says we do not have the capacity in this solar system to build more. So we're gonna buy more. What are we gonna buy more with, you ask? Well, up in the top corner we have our three types of materials, our three currencies: metal, crystal, and actual money. In the meantime, our dudes are fighting. Let's go see what kind of fighting is going on here. Yeah, we're gonna wreck house here, basically. Let's zoom in on this and see what's gonna happen. There's my curvy little ships, my Protossy dudes. What is going on? Why are we running away? You guys, we have some work to do here, you guys. Fight everything. We can also do attack queues as well, which is kind of handy. Oh yeah, that dude is he is hating it right now. Oh yeah, he's not gonna last long. All right, so they're gonna take care of that. Planet development complete. That means that the place, my dwarf planet that we got back here, let's go find it again. I'm going to zoom to the system level. No, it wasn't the dwarf planet. It was my home planet. I said my home planet. I said. There we go. All right, so we built my Temple of Harmony, which means I can now do some research. So we're going to look up at the top up here. Every faction in this is basically asymmetrical. So I built a Harmony Temple, so we're going to do some Harmony things. Research upgrade. Sure, let's do that. Knowledge of your people's desert origins is rediscovered, inspiring many to flock to desert planets. Well, we have no desert planets on the map yet, so we're not going to deal with that. Our Temple of Harmony also allows us to do bounty hunters. No. Voice of the Unity. Relationships. This is not really what I had in mind when I built that Temple of Harmony. Where can I melt people's faces with science and spirituality? Well, it turns out I can't yet because I didn't have the logistics to build a Temple of Hostility, which we're going to go ahead and build that right now. So that's going to take a little bit of time. In the meantime, we're going to zoom out and take a quick look here. Looks like we killed some more dudes. Look, and in fact, we get some free guys. What are these guys all about? They are some missile thrower dudes, and they are a little independent faction that's here to save the day, I guess. Everybody, let's go to this volcanic planet. Now, we're slowly, as we move away from our, I don't know what that was. A commodity boom is taking place. Is that? Yes, commodities. We have some good commodities. In fact, something I forgot to do is we've got some asteroids here that we need to start harvesting. Remember the metal and the crystal that we were talking about earlier? Well, guess what? We're going to send our little dudes and this little worker drone here. Looks like he's making kind of a face. He is going to go to these asteroids here. And he's going to build some stuff. You can see we have a little ghosty area that's eventually going to fill up. So this will be a crystal asteroid. All of the resources that you get come through in terms of units per second. So even though this is a 4X game, ooh, let's be careful here. Let's see. So that is a volcanic planet. You know what? We are not going to go to that asteroid quite yet. What's this? A greenhouse planet. You know what? We're going to send some dudes that way. In fact, we're going to go back here and we are going to build. Cool thing is that you can just click on a system and all of the facilities of that system are available to you. So you can build more of anything you want to. We need to do some research. Hopefully that Temple of we don't want diplomacy. Yes, we have some hostility points here. All right. So, purge vessel. We don't need anything that's going to kill planets yet. Acolytes. Yeah, let's go ahead and build. We'll research the ability to build those, as well as Titans. I mentioned earlier that we were going to try and do Titans. I am not sure in the time that we've got allotted that we're going to do that. Notice that on each of these things that I click on, there is a cost. So, for example, this basic shield projection is going to take 400 metal and 25 crystal. Sorry, 400 coins and 25 crystal. We've got that money. We're going to spend it. This stuff all happens basically in the order that you click. So you can see this little tiny meter that's filling up here, and it is just going to happen in the background. So I'm going to load up on some hostility hangars. So we can also fortify our zones. So I'm going to build a hangar because we've got some pirates out here. One of the other things in Sins of a Solar Empire that you have to be careful about is this pirate planet right here. Which is currently in the fog of war. We cannot see anything in there, but it is loaded with pirates. Pirates get restless on a pretty regular schedule, actually. And this red line, this line that here that's filling up, represents the schedule. This also here next to this dude, this is my bad guy dude over here. You can see he's on the other end of this zone. And by the way, you can see our little fleets moving around, so they're going to be doing their thing. But him over here, he currently has no bounty on his head. I'm going to give him a little bit of bounty. The reason is that once the pirates have met the end of their restlessness meter, oh good, we just researched some corvettes. Let's build some of those. Build some, build some, build one of those too. The pirates are going to attack whoever is the most lucrative target, and you basically want to make sure that it's not you. So we've just gotten the announcement of that pirate raid. It's going to be happening anytime. And we're getting pretty close here. I currently don't have any bounty on me that I'm aware of. Where do I see that? I totally forget where I can see my own bounty. I don't know. Hopefully the pirates don't come for me, but that's why I've got those hangars. The thing that I'm not sure about, though, is if the pirates come for me, which direction are they going to come from? I think technically the number of hops, one, two, three to get to me, one, two, three, they could come from either way. So let's just throw some more money and hope that they go after the bad guy. Hopefully you do not see a pirate raid during the course of the stream tonight. That would constitute something very negative. We don't want to see that. I'm just gonna wait here for a second. Like, this is the moment where you kind of wait just to make sure that someone doesn't. Oh, and you can see my little fleet moving, doing their thing. Okay, it'll tell you. Pirate raid launched for the Luapika colonist territory. Great, so he has to deal with them. Perfect. I have no bounty on me. I'm cool with that. All right, everybody. You've got to, like, get this together. Kill those guys. Oh, yeah, reinforcements. Obliteration! So this is that new thing that we just built. Oh, super sleek looking. Looks like some kind of moth. Kill those dudes. So he also, this little Corvette has some kind of debuffing capabilities as well. Don't understand totally how it works, but guess what? I don't need to be bothered with that right now. Also, my big ships are going to be gaining experience as we go, and I actually have the ability to purchase another level. He's gained enough experience that it's only going to cost 112 coins. What the heck? Let's do that. So I now have the ability to add a new upgrade. I can regenerate the shields of friendly targets. That's pretty handy. Causes affected enemies to suffer damage whenever any one of them is damaged by weapons fire. We're going to go defensive. I think the longer you can last, the better off you're going to be. So we'll let those guys do their thing. Currently still okay on pirates. However, we want to expand into some other territories here. We have Greenhouse Planet available over here, which we have not explored. Well, actually, we have explored it 500 seconds ago, in fact. It has a few dudes on it. We also have this fire planet here, this volcanic planet. We need to take a look in our research tree over at the Harmony area. That's where all of your domestic templates are. So Greenhouse and Volcanic. So basically, the first level here, our first temple, we unlocked the ability to research these things. Let's do that too. We need another Temple of Harmony in order to get to that second level. So, since we're maxing out on our homeworld, we are going to zoom in and we are going to build a Temple of Harmony here. So, go build that, you guys. Alright, in the meantime, my auto-colonizing dude is auto-colonizing. By the way, we're going to go ahead and just max out our resources here. By the way, new planets, kind of expensive. We need to build some civilian infrastructure on our little planets. Build one there, build one there. You'll notice that on the right-hand side, the tax rate currently is going to cost me money right now, so I'm actually losing money on these planets until I upgrade them. So currently, this planet is netting me a minus 1.5 credits per second income rate. We are going to change that by going to even Steven. And then I don't have any credits to make it any better. But you know what? That's a decent investment. We're gonna go ahead with that. All right. Anytime now, we are going to have knowledge acquired. We've just finished some research. And we finished some construction. I don't know on what, though. Let's... 500 credits and 50 crystal for better hull. Yeah, let's do it. All right, we're spending. Spending. Thanks for joining us, by the way. If you're just tuning in, this is the Game Byte Show podcast. I'm Jeremy Lawman Lamont, and we are playing Sins of a Solar Empire Rebellion, one of the most fun 4X games, I think, of my gaming career. Really enjoy this one. I hope you do, too. We can also spend some money to do some other cockamamie things like explore planets. Sometimes you can get some cool little bonuses. Let's go ahead and throw some money at that and give it a minute and see if anything comes of it. So currently running a little bit low on money at the moment. Got to be careful where I spend that extra dough. Let's see. Where's my guys? All right. So we need to start. We're going to move in on these guys. So let's zoom in real close. Here's my little fleet. Let's tell them all to jump together. So they can fly in formation, which is kind of cool. And they're going to just go to the edge. So this circular area, this is the edge of this territory. They're going to plot a course for here. I told them to go to that greenhouse world. So they're all going to wait until they get in line here, which is kind of cool. And they're all going to jump together. These guys are going to dock in eventually. A divine artifact. Hey, we got something. Bombardment shelters on Eos. It's pretty good if you're getting bombarded, I guess. Not too awesome for me right now at this stage of the game. We're gonna need another temple of. Let's make this interesting. We're gonna build a temple of hostility here. Temple of hostility. Bam. See what that's. And actually, even before you build it, you can kind of see what your next thing is going to be. So now that that construction is kind of beginning, we can actually begin to see what the new things are. Repair platforms, defense vessels, support ships, light weapons for protecting the fleet against strike craft. There are no strike craft to defend against. Drones. I'm all about drones. We're going to get some drones. In the security area, we're going to be getting hangars, mines. Mines are super helpful. We won't deal with mines quite yet. Now, technically, this faction that I'm playing is they're all about being empathic. I just don't know. Greater returns for the credits your empire spends on bounty. Fine. Fleet logistics. We need to think about this too, because fleet logistics is where you can buy the ability to get more dudes. All right, come on, everybody. What are we waiting for here? Kick it in the butt. Go. Everybody. Everybody, come on, you're killing me. What are you doing? That's the wrong direction. Who is the captain? Who's in there? That's right. Point back that way, smart guy. Ah, so hard to find good help. There we go. All right, everybody. We're gonna make this work. Everybody all together now. Bam. All right. Now these guys got left behind, so. Oh, there they go. Come on, dudes. There you go. All right. Catching up with our main fleet here. Just about to land at our destination. Oh, which means we need to research. The whole point of this was to go to Harmony, research greenhouse planets, so that once that's done, we'll be able to colonize that thing. All right, everybody. We're gonna set a specific attack order here. We're gonna get this guy, this guy, this guy, and then that guy. Turn off the auto colonization. That will not be helpful. Yes, please do those things. Yeah? Talk is cheap. Oh, hello. Somehow we have dudes that are fighting up here. What is going on, dudes? All right, we need to help the dudes. I don't know if we're going to be on time here, but we need to do some research. Research into fleet logistics. We need to get another command point here. Command points will allow us to get more big capital ships, which is what we want. All right, everybody, fight, fight, fight. Fight, fight harder. I don't think we're going to be saving these dudes anytime soon. Oops. Keep forgetting how the zoom function works. Oh no. There's more dudes than we've got. We need more dudes. Sorry, dudes. You know what? And even if we could get this done fast enough, they're so far away. There are too many jumps. So what's it going to take to build another capital ship here? We need fleet. We also need 3,000 money. Here's another cool thing we can do. We can sell our stuff. Let's kind of take a look at the market here. On the black market, we have prices for the metal and the crystal, which is what we had talked about before. You can buy metal currently for 2.4. You can actually kind of see here it's not at a bad price. We can sell 100 for the price of 241. I kind of think we want to go ahead and do that. There we go. Now we've sold a bunch of our metal. I'm down to 1700 metal, but I have enough money now that I can build a nice capital ship as soon as the research is complete on this logistics item. Oh no, I did the wrong thing. Command does not. No, yes it does. Yes it does. Increase the number of capital ships. What are we waiting for? Oh, I'm at fleet capacity too. I need to upgrade both of those things. So up here is the number of ships I can actually afford to field. There we go. So that thing needs to finish the bar, but it'll actually let me start this fast. Battleship. How are the dudes doing here? Dudes, hang in there, dudes. If we can manage this, it'll be pretty amazing. I don't think it's going to work. So currently, in my little capital ship, remember when we started at the very beginning? Currently nobody here in the O-ring waiting to be built, because we've got to wait for this research to finish, and then we've got to wait for this to build. So, again, I am not sure about the dudes. Let's go back over here, where it looks like we are victorious. We have successfully researched, yes, in harmony. We did finish the greenhouse planet. So let's go ahead and... Oh, someone showed up to get his butt kicked. Colonize that planet. Let's see what this looks like when we colonize a planet. Because, you know, here's the thing. I'm doing a lot of abstract stuff in menus, and hopefully you're getting a good idea. Ooh, pirate raids. Throw some money at that dude. Stuff is actually literally happening while I'm doing my menus. So technically we can actually watch here as, hopefully, any moment now. Oh, there we go, little colony pods. There you go, colony pods. Off to start a new life. And this guy banks around because he is ready to kick some booty right here. Let's see what's going on with these guys. So these jerks just kind of showed up just in time to get a whooping. In the meantime, oh no. Okay, that's what it is. Whoever has the most bounty, their picture appears here. You never want your picture here. And I need to pay close attention to this, because this is just like eBay, where they're going to snipe me right at the last minute. So I got to be careful about this. Until the pirates actually launch, I got to keep my eye on this little menu right here. It's happened to me before. Like, I think I've got it in the bag, and then suddenly pirates are coming after me. Come on, pirates. Come on, pirates. I do not want you... I'm sorry, it would be entertaining to see a pirate raid coming at me, but we do not want that, so we're not going to see it tonight. Hopefully. Oh no, what's going on? Okay, good. Pirate raiders in their territory. Awesome, that's just what we want. Oh, the dudes! Oh, you know what? I think the dudes just lost. So, didn't really work. Capital ship complete. Here's our big ship. It doesn't look like much by itself. We're going to set you as group two, Broheim. Why are you going the long way around like that? Stop it. We want you to go here. Yeah, can you do that? Can you do that, big boy? All right. What are his abilities? Detonate antimatter. That uses people's energy against them. Animosity antagonizes hostile forces into attacking this ship. So here's his tank ability. Energy absorption. Slight increase to armor. You know what? Let's go with the tankity tank skill. I think he can take it. So we also need to build some dudes to go with him. Build. Oh no, we are. No, that's the wrong thing. We don't want to build from there. We want to build from this frigate factory. We also have cruisers. Let's build a drone cruiser. And let's build two or three of these and one of those guys and just tell them, hey, everybody, go with him. The other one... You know, we also have down the left-hand side, I haven't talked about this at all, but we have this whole menu down this end here. We can actually tell these guys... Oh, hey, look. I see a little plus on the icon next to my dude. Guess what? He got a new ability that he can use. So he can actually do several things. Causes affected enemies to suffer damage when any one of them... Sure, we'll do that one. All right. So how are we going to do this now with the dudes? No, dudes are somewhere else. We're going to build some infrastructure on this planet so that it doesn't cost us so much money. We're gonna build. Oh, we're out of money. We're down to 50 monies. Let's go to the black market. Currently, monies are increasing in value. Let's leave those there for now. Let's check out group two here. Here's our big ship. Oh, yeah. So this guy's made for fighting. Let's zoom in real close on him. Oh, he's got a shield and everything. Look at that bubble that goes around him. Nobody's touching this guy. He's doing a broadside. Look, he's taking them all on at once. This dude, he's a freaking hero. Yeah, they're barely touching his shields. Actually, they're doing a decent amount of damage on his shields. So we're going to make sure that hopefully he gets some dudes soon. Where are his friends? Friends. Oh no, the friends are going the wrong way. These are bad friends. All right, fine, fine. You can sense me. Just go to where I tell you to. You know what? Let's just send all these guys to help him. Because they were supposed to in the first place. What is going on here? Somewhere I must have screwed up these orders because... Oh, you know what I did? I think I know exactly what I did. I think when I went to look at my other guy's special levels that he leveled up, I think I inadvertently told people to go there. All right, so we've got a nice planet over here. We're going to take that one too. So everybody on our little colonizing cruise, let's go make it work. More infrastructure. We want it. Where is our dude number two? Dude number two. I need to unpin some of this stuff. This is getting insane over here on the left. And it can get pretty complicated. Yep, here's our guy. Alright, so we're back where we belong. We're gonna take this volcano planet. Yeah, everybody here, they're gonna be doing just fine. Alright, so just make sure that everybody's on the same boat here. Everybody kill. That'll be fine. So if you don't have a ship that has colonizing, this might be a good opportunity for me to build a little colony ship. So back at our home planet, we're going to build a missionary vessel. And we're also going to build another couple of these. Sometimes you just find yourself throwing in a couple of extra ships just to reinforce people from time to time. Now, this planet is super adjacent to those pirates. We do not want that. And everybody just go there. Oop, I'll let them take off. We're going to build some more of you and some more of you. And we're going to build a frigate factory here. We want to start to be able to build more ships. And we are going to imbue this planet with some logistics. Nope, tactical capacity. We need more money. We need more money. That's right. We were going to be on the black market here. Looks like metal is high. This orange line here is about as high as it can get. Let's just spam the sell button for a minute. Trade in some of that metal for some sweet, sweet cash. And we're going to build some tactical capacity into this planet. That means we're going to be able to build some things. Since, remember, in our research tree in our security section, we had built hangars. We also want to research mines. Mines are pretty handy. Let's go see what's going on over here. Is everyone doing all right over here? Big guy, you doing good? Oh, that's our drone dude. Drone dude, deploy some of them drones. Oh, we need bombers. So he's basically a carrier, and he's shaped like a giant snail, and I just had him ram some guys. That's fine, he'll be okay. All right, everybody just keep fighting. Keep fighting. Research, time for research. Mines are being researched. Hostility, we want more shields. We want some repair stuff. Defense vessels. Haven't seen any fighter craft yet. Augmented launchers. Planet bombardment. We are not going to be doing that, so we don't need it. Improved containment. Yeah, we're going to get some better fighties. Oh, good. Our guy just got a level up. So he also gets some fighters. We're going to give him some bombers. Fighters are for fighting fighters. Bombers are for bombing. That's the rule of thumb. So remember, fighters, fighting, bombers, bombing. So what bombers will do is bombers will attack corvettes. Fighters are basically only for attacking other strike craft. So we just launched these little guys. Go, little guys. Zoom it in. Shoot someone, shoot someone. Bounty has been depleted. Meaning that, oh, I forgot to level up this guy. Oh, goodness. That didn't seem good. He's getting shot at, effectively. More abilities. Sure. Pirates, pirates, pirates. Knowledge acquired. What did we just research? Mines. Reinforcements, good. All right, so I think, oh, we need to research under Harmony Arctic planets. Hopefully that goes quickly. Yeah. Anyway, in just a minute we'll be able to, oh, there's some dudes. We just need to kill those dudes. You know, it's kind of funny. You'd think that this guy shaped like a gun. He would actually... Oh, he just sprayed out some stuff. Majestic. Majestic. Oh, there's what it looks like when you gain a level. I'm so pleased to be able to show you that. So he just killed enough guys that we can level him up with something. More shields? More shields? I think more shields. Whoops, I gotta stop doing that. And in the meantime, our big dudes here... oh, you know what? We built a missionary vessel somewhere. Where did that thing go? Nope. What happened to that dude that I built? I wonder if he flew somewhere and got killed. I think we can do a search here. Mission. Let's see. Colony ships. Of course he flew over there with the other dude. All right. You know what I need to do here? I need to turn off all of the like auto follow people thing. So go back to that colony ship. You, my friend. Oh. You're never going to make it through there. Go the long way around. Here, then here, then here, then here. I can't believe you did that, you useless. All right. Oh, let's colonize that. Colonize it. All right, so we researched our ice planet. Pirate raid. Put some money on that guy. Infrastructure. I forget that we've been getting planets this whole time. I need to start building some more things. Oops, actually, I don't want that. Build some logistical structures. Build some of those. Let's get another temple of hostility. And that's probably okay for now. Up here. So we've got a little blue dude here who's basically... checking us out with impunity. There's not really much we can do about it. We don't have anybody there. So that's our bad blue guys that we haven't even met yet. Another planet joins the Unity. Let's go over there and check it out. So this is where we just colonized the ice planet. Oh, I'm glad those pirate raiders did not depart for me. Excellent, excellent. So we haven't seen any real good fleet action yet, and I kind of would like to give you the chance to see that before we wrap up for the night. I mean, we have seen some fighting, I suppose. All right. Shattered moons. Let's do this. Let's accelerate things a little bit. And we're just going to start moving in on these guys. So I just sent my fleet number one with my colonizing ship and my fleet number two with my my battleship here. We're going to send those guys all together to wreck house just a little bit. Look at how they all go to mommy. Fly home to mommy. Oh, phase jump. We got to see it. Still cool. I like to do it from the side because then you can see it kind of like, bam, it just like takes off. Fun. Okay. So we're going to bring this to a crescendo for the end of the show tonight. Where is that colony ship? He is super slow. This guy. Like, he's full of people, and he just did like... Oop, I can see his hole there. Alright, he's making his way back. Idiot. Alright, and there's our guys going to the Shattered Moon over there, trying to bypass the... Now, who are all these? Send those two. No, don't go that way. All right. Let's get some more ships. Capital ship or little ships? Capital ship, capital ship. So once that finishes, we need some money to get some dudes. So guess where we're going to go? We're going to the black market because we got a ton of metal to sell again. Now's a good time. Sell, 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 sell. Sell. Perfect. And what do we want to build next? Let's see. A battle cruiser. Firepower for the ability to manipulate enemy populations. Psionic abilities. Ooh, that sounds cool. A Discord battleship. Yeah, let's do that. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm actually going to go ahead and tell our special guy here to send that ship off to the ice planet. So we actually have some guys here. Their little home fry militia here. So remember also on this greenhouse planet, we did build a frigate factory, so let's make use of this. Let's build some stuff. Let's build a carrier, and we'll build a discipleship or two. What's going on here? That's our big guy. All bounty has been depleted. So here's the thing. The other thing that's been going on that we haven't been able to look at is what's been happening with all of these pirates that keep coming. Thing is, just want to make sure that my colony ship is going to do okay here whenever it decides to finally show up. Missionary vessel right here. Where is he? Where is he besides being an idiot? I don't know. I don't know where he is. Research. Research. We don't want harmony right now. See the incoming ships. Indoctrinate others. Build structures faster. You know what? We want some hostility stuff here. That's really what we want. Illuminators. Yes, please and thank you. Speaking of yes, please and thank you. Did that ship end up getting built? Where did he go? There he is. This is our new guy. Look how much he looks like a giant bug. A beautiful giant bug who clips right through your asteroids. Let's give him some abilities. Armor is telekinetically weakened. Affected by a sonic, dealing moderate damage and preventing them from using their abilities. We'll do that one. Yeah, how'd you like to see one of those guys coming down on you? You would not. You definitely would not. Alright, so he's on his way. The little home fry militia looks like they got pretty well taken care of. Let's kill his little metal extractor there. Oh, let's see what it looks like to see a fractured moon. Fractured moon is not targetable. So I've got to use the old manual. Hey, that's cool. Never really seen one of those before. It looks like something from Destiny. Different game. All right. Send some more. Send some more. Illuminators. Yes. Yes. Yes, and one of those. All of the things. And you guys need to start. Nope, don't go that way. So help me, you guys. If somebody decides to take a shortcut through that pirate planet... Oh, there's our big battleship. Where is our voice needed? I'll tell you where it's needed. Up there on that shattered moon. Alright, did our missionary vessel ever actually make it over there? You had better be scooting it over there. Can't believe he's just sitting there. Why is everyone incompetent? Just do what I intended for you to do, not what I told you to do. Oh, we need to load this dude up. So even people who are in transit, you can give them commands. Homing mines. Yeah. Too good to pass up homing mines, but I think we better just stick with some standard bombers. All right, so he's on his way. All right, so here are our two fleets. It looks like everybody's all linked up here. Let's just wait for our battleship here to make his way over. Everybody together. All together now. I feel comfortable telling him just to go with that guy. Cruisers. Insufficient fleet capacity. So we need to do a little bit of research. Get a little bit more fleet capacity. By the way, notice, of course, that the higher your fleet capacity, the more the cost. Who cares? We're going to do it. We're also going to, you better believe our fleet has arrived. Gonna do some better reactors. Gonna do some little helper craft. In fact, we're gonna build some of those helper crafts. We're out of money. You know what you do when you're out of money? Go to the black market where metal is at a high price. Build one of you. Yep. All right. All right, what's everybody doing? Everybody get in position here. We're going to get ready to jump. Oh, goodness. Somehow I have more fleet than I have capacity for. Slowly but surely bringing this to a head. We are going to end this tonight. More dudes showed up. And just in time for my... guess what everybody goes for, by the way, when your colonization ship shows up. Yep, everybody goes for your colonization ship. So this guy trekked clear across the galaxy to get shot at by this jerk. He's got some kind of machine gun that he uses. You know what, though? Launch those colonists. The Unity senses a pirate raid. The interesting thing is, remember how I said that you're not going to get to see a pirate raid? I think I'm actually going to get caught in the middle of a pirate raid. Because if I send the pirates to my bro, Blue Bro, and I'm lying in wait for Blue Bro, I am not sure what's going to go down here. I don't think it's going to be pretty. Colonize this. Colonize it. Colonize it. Oh, there goes that guy. Colonize. Here's some more money. Colonize. Oh, that's what's left of, Oh, you know, he doesn't have enough energy to do it yet. So we'll come back to him. All right, everybody. All right, so here's the thing. Let's make this happen. Everybody go together. Oh, those pirate raiders, they're going to come in right behind me. Guess where that planet is? I'll show you where that planet is. It's right here. Guess where they're going? Over here. Same as me. So, well. In fact... I kind of feel like... Yeah, I don't know what's happening, but, that unit cannot phase jump. It sure would be handy if they could, though. See, there they are. Here they come, and they don't really care who they were originally going for. They're going to be attacking this thing, I think. You guys better get back home. Oh, they're not attacking that extractor. Yeah, they are bypassing that extractor. And I will be interested to see if they start shooting my guys. Let's see my giant fleet all go together. All right, everyone. Hold hands. Here we go. All right. We're going to just make everybody... Nah, there's no purpose in that. All right, so those pirates are going to basically be right behind us. And I think once they show up, they are pretty much just going to go into a frenzy. Oh, so those are the pirates left over from the last time. That's a little maniacal. Oh, so there's the guy... This is going to be a huge mess. This is going to be a huge mess. So what we're going to do is... We're going to switch this over to cinematic mode. How do I do that? cinematic view right here. And we're just going to watch this kind of play out, actually. I don't think I really need to give my guys a lot of extra. So they're attacking those pirates. I don't really care about attacking the pirates. Maybe we should turn off cinematic mode for a second, because I need to see what's going on over here. Those drone dudes need to kind of get away. That guy should not be fighting our people. Like, we need to be really, like, killing these things. Oh, gosh. All right. Well, let's go ahead and switch it back to cinematic mode. We'll zoom it in on this guy, and we'll just kind of watch and see what happens here. Some things are happening. We don't know exactly what they all are, but people are getting shot. Pretty sure. Hopefully we're gonna win. I think I can turn off all the HUD though. Let's do that. Can I do that? I don't think I can. If I can, I think it might be a little bit too. Sound effects, network, display, video? Video, no. All right, whatever. We're just going to watch it as is. So, everybody, thank you for joining us for the Game Bytes show tonight. We have been playing Sins of a Solar Empire Rebellion. Stuff has been happening, as you can see, and damned if I know. Damned if I know what's going on. Oh, you know what? Our guys are getting levels, so we need to make sure to. In fact, here's what we're going to do. Move him over here. Quit bombarding that planet. You've got bigger fish to fry. It is kind of fun to see the effects of the planet bombardment, though. You can just imagine all of the people, like, screaming in horrible hellfire. All right, so we just moved this guy over, and he's gonna equalize a little bit here. So as I was saying, this has been the Game Bytes Show video stream, and we certainly have enjoyed having you here. As you may know, we do these streams once per week here at twitch.tv/GameBytesShow. If you happen to be watching the glorious, glorious archive of our great pirate victory, where you can see the battleship here has antagonized successfully all of the pirates, which allows everyone else to kind of do their business as they need to, including Bugman. Remember to subscribe to us on twitch.tv/GameBytesShow. Hit that subscribe button. Be notified when we go live. Someone is dying. Someone is getting the crap kicked out of them. Bugman seems to be hurting a little bit. Won't be long though. Won't be long. We'll make space great again. Gonna make outer space great again. Hit that subscribe button. You can also subscribe to us on YouTube and get notified when we post our great streams. If you have any suggestions for us, you can reach out to us on social media. On Twitter, we can be found collectively at Game Bytes Show. If you're interested in gabbing at me personally, I am at Jeremy_Lamont. You can also find our other compadres. Normal streaming buddy, Jared Red Eye Dunn, is at RED_I. We also have a podcast that we do with a couple of other guys, Legrand Jolly at Legrand, LEGRANDE, and Dale Jones at Count Elmdor. Let's watch the glorious pursuit here. This is our most damaged ship, and I think this guy's running away. I think he's gonna get away. But yeah, there goes his jump. So he'll get away. He'll live to fight another day, unfortunately. Yes, so definitely also check out that audio podcast that I mentioned. You can find that over on our website, gamebyteshow.com. You can subscribe to us on RSS or on iTunes, however suits you most. Also, send your friends. Let them know that you're able to watch cool space strategy simulators, all kinds of fun and nifty things going on here at the Game Bytes Show. Our podcast is twice a week, and we make sure to cover you for games that we've been playing, as well as talking to you about the news, new releases, and special video game topics that you will love to listen to. Again, thank you so much for joining us on the Game Bytes show. I think we just exploded someone. That's positive. That's actually really good. Perhaps this guy. Unless they shot my guy. I don't really know what happened there. But your guess is as good as mine. Again, thank you so much for joining us for the Game Bytes show video stream. And we will see you next time. Ciao.